sides of this because we think it's twofold. And so first, really quickly, we're going to talk about retaining loyal customers. And so I kind of want to just start real quickly. Here at It Works Global, our loyal customer program is amazing, but the question is, how do we make loyal customers loyal? You know, and so let's start with you, Amber. Like, what's one tip that you could give this group today that you've seen that has been effective in retaining loyal customers?
One is be there for them. Okay, don't sign up a loyal customer and then just be like, cool, I got my customer. You have a customer, you now have a friend, you now have residual income, okay? So one thing I do is, I'm old school, you guys. I print out my steps to success. I write their name down. I write what product they use. And on the first of every month, I pull out the last month, the month before that, and usually the 6 months prior, okay? And I literally go through my loyal customers, and it takes me just a handful of minutes, not very long, because I write them down, and I just follow up with them, and I say, hey, how are you liking the greens? Did you want to try the probiotic as well this month? Switch it up for them. Educate them on the sister products. Educate them on, you know, you've got this many perk points. I'm so excited for you. Your 3 months is done, you know? So following up on the first with them and making sure that they know that you're available as well, because, you know, when they're confused, they're not gonna order anything. So if you can educate them on that, that's where they stick around for a little bit longer. And of course, for life is what the ultimate goal is.
Oh, that's really good. Brooke, let's go to you real quick. What do you do to retain loyal customers?
Okay, so who here is all the colors but green? That would be me. So I was having a really hard time figuring out like a simple way to keep all my loyal customers in one spot. And Brianna Swindle, you changed my life with this tip. So every single time you get an email with a new loyal customer, all you do is just flag it. And then this creates a new folder of all flagged loyal customers. So now I have them all organized in one spot with all of their ID numbers, their auto ship dates. I send them an email, and then now I'm taking it a step further because it makes me feel just so good about my life right now that I just started doing this 4 years in, that you're never too late. I have been snail mailing them product brochures, which is a little note saying, thank you so much for being my customer. Please reach out if you need anything. And I feel like then they're thinking, oh gosh, she knows me. She knows where I'm gonna stop ordering. Yeah, I'm looking at them. So I think that's a great tip.
Well, that was a great tip about finding emails. Rachel, how about you?
I've got two, and the very first one is just to add on to theirs, is that we are customer service. So don't push your customers to customer service. Take care of them as much as you can by yourself, because they came to you and they ordered from you, and so you can make them so much happier. And I know that when I've had an unhappy customer, I mean, I've done my best just to get on the phone, apologize for anything, and even just send them a little package, like with a cute little note. Like, hey, I'm so sorry this happened. Here's a week of green samples. I know that you'll love them. This is my favorite. Something like that, just going the extra mile in customer service will change everything for your ability to keep them on and keep ordering. The other one is something that I recommend for VIPs out there. And if you're not attached to like somebody that you know, like a presidential diamond ambassador, then you can do it yourself. But to start a page for your loyal customers, and then every time you enroll a distributor, have them also add their customers to this page too. What it does is that it just creates community for your customers, and it's something that you then can then post on. If there's a BOGO, hey, guess what? There's a BOGO going on. Make sure you get your wraps ordered. If you have any questions, let me know, comment below or something. But you will be amazed at how many people see that, and then they pop in, they make their order, and then you just got paid. So it's an awesome way to keep your customers organized as well.
That's really good. So normally when we do a retention panel, we do, like, our minds instantly go to talking about loyal customers. But I would almost venture to say that just as important, if not more important than retaining loyal customers, is retaining distributors. And I think that we probably all can learn a little bit about that. And so I'm gonna just go right back to each of you and say, like, let's start with you, Brooke. What do you do to retain distributors in your organization?
I think with our team in particular, our community is so strong. So let me just paint a picture for you. Who has ever like hosted a dinner party or anything like that? You've got a group of friends you've known forever, but you're kind of trying to introduce some new friends into the mix, and you feel that pressure of, oh gosh, I've got to make sure that I connect them with so-and-so so they feel included. And it's a lot of pressure, but the second you start seeing those two people talking, you're like, oh, thank goodness, they're having a good time, and you can kind of let them just enjoy themselves. Because if they don't connect with that person, usually they're like, hey, I'm gonna peace out before dessert. Sorry, gotta go.
But if they find somebody to connect with, they're gonna stay and hang out and start feeling more comfortable. So that's what we do with our team. The second that I have somebody sign, I'm connecting them with somebody. That doesn't mean I'm placing them on their team. That means usually sidelines. I'm making sure that they are becoming friends. We go out to coffee. If they're not close together, we do a Zoom, and I'm making sure that they have a buddy. And you know, people are going to love this business and these products, but they are gonna also stay so loyal to these friends. And I've watched sideline team members on my team be at each other's weddings. That's who they call in their darkest moments. And I promise you, they are staying because they absolutely love their family on our team.
Yeah, I think Pam just did it. How many of you, some of your best friends are in this business? Look at that. Like, that's how powerful community is. A lot of people will join this business not just to make money, but just because they need friends. And so we need to keep that in mind, and that's a good way to retain distributors. Rachel, how about you?
I like doing Zooms because a lot of us have community, family across the United States, maybe even outside of that. And so doing Zooms are wonderful. FaceTime is wonderful. And Facebook now, you have Messenger. Did you guys know you have video in there too? Oh my gosh, I was videoed, like I can videotape with anyone. And one-on-ones is so amazing. I tried group messaging for a while and it didn't work. Honestly, like that one-on-one relationship goes so far, you guys. If they sign with you, they want to know you, and you need to know them. So they're not just a number to plug in, okay? Like your people are your people, and you need to know them and build a relationship with them and really care about their needs, their whys, and their wants. And by doing that, that relationship goes deep, like she was saying, and it does create community. And even locally, building my community and doing wrap parties as a group, saying, hey, grab your friends and your friends and your friends, and we'll have another one next week, and then you bring them and them and then, and then all of a sudden you've got this huge crowd of people that you're doing wrap parties for. So that community, I just feel like goes so far. Building relationships through social media, you can do that the same.
Absolutely. Ever, how about you?
One thing that I would really, really, really encourage you to do, and this is from, you know, being a manager in a salon, flipping a salon, I mean, so many different leadership positions that I've held, but you have to create the win, okay? You want to get your new distributor a win as fast as possible. You know, I don't feel like, and maybe I'm completely off the board, but when you work at something for so long and you don't see that payoff or that payout, what do you want to do? You're like, it's just not worth my time. And so for me, the line of communication is first and foremost, who's their co-sponsor? I always tell people, you know, we work as a team, you're gonna have one or two other people helping you out. And the next thing we wanna do is wanna get those 4 customers. That steps to success, it's not like step one and then do 3 more steps and then go to step 2. It's step 1, step 2. Find those 4 customers, help them, give them a post to make, help them out with wording, how to respond to people. You know, they're already a little bit nervous, usually. I know I was. And so just, you know, be there for them, walk hand in hand with them, don't do it for them, but definitely be right there when they're ready for that win, you're ready to celebrate with them. And not only you, but they have a handful of other people that are gonna be celebrating with them. So again, the community and then getting them that win. They love it, and that will keep them in, you know, a couple months longer, if not forever.
Oh, that's really good. And so we have a few minutes left, and so we're gonna kind of do just like a really quick, like a fire drill type thing here. And so I guess we're the last panel. I didn't know we're the last panel. I feel really special. But one last thing you would tell this group today, maybe, you know, they're going for a bonus, maybe, you know, whatever it is, the last thing you would tell them regarding retention, like what would be one more tip you would give them that's really important to you? Rachel, will start with you.
Build life together, especially with your local team. Beyond just business. It doesn't always have to be business. Sometimes it could be, hey girls, anybody wanna take your kids to the park and play? And while they're playing, we can build a relationship, we can network together. Hey, anybody going to a coffee shop? I'm going to this one, you guys wanna come with me? We can do a power hour together. And so create moments and create urgency, not only for yourself, but for your team too, and build a local team, because that local team will change your life, and you'll gain friendships for life because of it too.
I love that. One thing that I would definitely encourage you guys to do is be available. Be available to your team. You know, and this is why also that line of communication is so strong, and if you start now,
you can't, you know, and Cammie always says, you can do anything, but you can't do everything. And so, you know, when you're at events like this, who do your distributors get to reach out to? Or do you notice that when you travel or when you're not absolutely in your house, like for some reason your team knows you're not in your house, they're like, oh, by the way, I'm not working anymore. You want them to be available, or if you're not available to them, know where they can go to find someone who's available. The only thing that's gonna hold your business back is to not, you know, not be available to them and help them, you know, when they need it, or direct them to that available option for their business to grow.
You know, I would just definitely have a why party. Make sure that you know every single person that's joining your team their why. So that way you can always help keep it in the forefront of their mind. And like Pam has said, so they're not a box, they're an actual person. And it's just gonna make your business mean so much more when you're sitting across from them and you can help them know that, hey, this next step is Ruby. Remember when you told me that all you wanted to do was be able to take your husband out on a date night? How good does that feel? Now let's go help you help your mom and dad go out on a date night this week. And just keep their why right in front of them.
Well, that's great. I had an old, a basketball coach who was older in high school, and he always used to look at me, and our coach here is way better than the coach I had back in high school, but he always used to say, a bird in the hand is, you know, worth, a bird in the hand is worth two in a bush. Have y'all ever heard that? And I think in this business, so many times we go searching in the bushes for that one, you know, that one runner, that one person who's gonna change our business. And so many times that bird in the hand's just staring back at you. They just need a little guidance. And that's really what retention is all about. And so look at your team, look at the value, look at the quality that's right in front of you. Look at what has been placed in your hand. And retention is a huge part of that. And so you haven't come this far to only come this far. And if you want to have a game changer in your business, start retaining those LCs and those distributors.